Hello everyone and welcome by the Orchid Saga. And I thought it would be time to do a blooming update for the month of October. And I'm starting here with my Peter Kamp. And well, officially it's a no idea, but I think it's a Peter Kamp, like I said. And it has two spikes still in bloom and one is going over. But beautiful blooms. Fragrant, not my preferred fragrance, but it's a nice fragrance. And next to it, we have still these beautiful blooms. And I hope it will focus. And it will not. I'm filming this in the evening, so there is a lot of light now in the back because of the artificial lights. But I hope you can see this. One spike left, and this is a cross, if I remember. Ringonia Asteria Alba. I'm sorry. So that's that one. We had about 8 spikes, if I remember correctly, on this one. And here above I have my Bartley Swartz, still in bloom. Let me see. I hope you can see the blooms now a bit better. 2 spikes there. Still, this one is going over now, but still beautiful. Then we have the Sunset. That was recently in a care collab. That was this one, the spotted one. And then a first rebloomer for me. Beautiful. And quite a lot of blooms on the Brassia Billabong. I think it's called Brassia still, but it's a Billabong. I had the Alba version in bloom and now I have the regular Billabong. But beautiful with that green and purple lip, beautiful colors, beautiful shape of blooms. And this one has 3 branches, beautiful branches. So it's a very large spike. Like I said, first rebloom, but it's doing a great job. Beautiful. So that with those on this side, I think I have still one left here. It's now going over as well. These ones, it's a Miltonia cross. Blue tea cross with Morliana. So now I'm going to turn around, head over to this side. The first spike is now over of my Purpurata, but it has another spike now in full bloom. Beautiful yellow and white and some pink blooms. And it's making a third spike as well, so I will have more blooms in the future. My Twinkles, this one is working on a spike here, so no blooms there. This is my yellow one, this is the biggest one, and this one has the first blooms open. Very beautiful tiny little blooms. And here are my Dendrobium Phalaenopsis, but I have a lot of, you can see, those are dead ones, this little black dots. Aphids, a lot of aphids, and they are not very hard, but they are still coming back and back, so that makes them quite annoying. And I sprayed these blooms quite a lot, so I think they are going over quicker than normal. And as you can see, not all of them are developing properly, some are dying off, so that's a bit sad, but yeah, the aphids are coming back and back and back. So I keep spraying. This is the Thailand Black with quite some spikes. I have one spike here, number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 spikes on this one. So that's beautiful. And I have another one here, also dealing with aphids and trips. So you see a lot of spots, but this is a beautiful bloom, and it's the Esmeralda. So yeah, that's very nice. Oh, I'm sorry, almost forget you guys here. This is also a beautiful one, a white one with a bit of green and purple in the lip. And you might recognize this one. That's called the Blue Happiness. One of the oldest Dendrobium Phalaenopsis that I have, next to the Purple Happiness. So So we have a lot of happiness going on here. Beautiful, right? I really enjoy growing them. But once again, this spike, it got over fairly quickly because of the aphids. Sadly, and here we have my wall of fowls. I hope you can see a lot of blooms, but still a lot of spikes and blooms to come, like on these guys. Beautiful buds here, and this one, a lot of branches, and this is my the one with the biggest blooms. It's just crazy. Look at my hand and the size of that bloom. Let me film it from the other side, and the fan is running, so let me turn it off quickly. There we go. But yeah, this one is so beautiful. It's not spectacular color-wise, but because of the size of the blooms. I can't remember that I saw one with bigger blooms than this. I think it's now even bigger than when I bought it. I found it at the IKEA. But yeah, I did go back because I just needed to have it. Beautiful. And I think this is my Bigfoot, also a very nice one. Opening up its blooms. And beautiful cascade one, no idea. And here you can see the traits of the aphids. Thrips. So yeah, I'm spraying. So I hope I will get them one day. But thrips are very hard to get rid of, in my experience. But yeah, it's what we all have to deal with sometime, with pests, I think. This white one is coming back. I did really mistreat it back in the days, one of my oldest ones. Also with fairly big blooms. But I found the pink one with even bigger blooms. And this is my Maya. Beautiful spotted one. Yeah. But as you can see, we have quite some spikes still to come. And what I like, this is my Leodora, one of my favorites. Again, the blooms are a little bit destroyed by thrips. But I have a branch here, and I think, this one's growing as well. So the older spikes are still working. They're still green, obviously, but they didn't do much for a fairly long time. But now they do, so therefore I just leave them on. This is also a very beautiful one. Color, I really like the color, and the way it blooms, very clustered. So yeah, it's very, very nice. Do I have blooms here? We do have spikes, also on my vendas, luckily, but not blooms yet. There is a spike as well here. So finally, in their new setup. And this one did attempt to bloom earlier on, but I had thrips, and spider mites. Thrips and spider mites on one spike, that was too much. So sadly, they did go. And my Cebidium as well. It's now going over, but the blooms were quite destroyed by thrips. We had two spikes, but I had my Cymbidium in bloom again. A bit early, I think, comparing to the rest of the growers in a sort of similar climate. And mine is also starting new growths. It has one there, or you can see it here, I think. That pointy thing sticking out there. Let me zoom in quickly. There, in the middle of the screen, that's a new growth. And I have one there, so something to look forward to, but it's fairly early, I think. And then this Cattleya, first rebloom for me, is starting to open up. Beautiful, it's beautiful colors, if you ask me, for those who wants to know which one it is. Leus Joysens Golden Leopards. Yes, beautiful, I think. And my Cassidiae are not doing much, except this one. This one is almost starting to bloom. And it had another spike here, and it did try to open it up because it came from this side and grew underneath those leaves. So I thought, well, I'm going to give it a little bit room. And then it started to die off the day after it, when I make some room. So, yeah, I didn't... want any interference, I guess. But yeah, something to look forward to. Then I still have this one, the kiwi, Doll Kiwi in Bloom. Also on a care collab with Nina. We were together on that one. But this one is still blooming. So, let me see. Not much going on here. But we'll have one look at the fails. I really enjoy it. So beautiful. So let's go inside the orchid room and have a look at the blooms there. First one here is the Alkmaar in bloom again, and the fan is just starting now. I think it's okay. My Nelly Eilers are still in bloom. They're starting to get a little bit paler, but they're still there. And then we have this one in bloom. This one I really like as well because of the colors, the brown and orange. And this is the, I need to check, Ada Glossom, French Town, Ada Glossom. Beautiful, beautiful one. Sadly, the plant itself is not really looking great, but it's growing well for me for years now. It has a second spike there. Beautiful moss in a pot. So I'm not completely sure what's going on here, but yeah, luckily it's still growing. And oh yeah, this one is blooming as well. This one is quite often mistaken with the come on brain, with the Bartley Swartz. There it was. It does look similar, but it's not the Bartley Swartz. It's a Miltodium Rankinens Grandeur. I don't think you can read the letters, but yeah, so it looks a bit the same, but it's not the same plant. I've got mine from the Incas. They sell it, and we have still the Sturbic Red for months now. This is the sixth spike it gave me. Beautiful colors, but this one really, really likes to bloom. Grows fairly well and likes to bloom. So that's a beautiful one to have if you like blooms, red big blooms. Then we have this beauty. Beautiful one, and I think I found the idea. I'm sorry, there it is. Crytoniopsis amethyst gem. Not completely sure, but I really do think that this is this one. Beautiful blooms, and this has absolutely the most beautiful fragrance in my opinion. It's just roses, old English roses, beautiful. Next to it, it's a no idea. But it does look shape-wise a little bit similar, but I couldn't find an idea. So if you have any idea, you can see the blooms when they open up, they're a bit darker, and then they lighten up quite quickly. Just 1-2 days, and then they start to get this color, more pinkish color. But if you're a beautiful display, and I really like the white and the yellow on the lip. Combination of white and yellow in blooms I really, really like. I don't know why, but I really like it. Then we have this Saigo. A fairly new one. And I did a repot video on it, so if I don't forget, I will link it if you are curious. But I have it in bloom again. Two spikes. Let me check. Zygonesia Cosmo Murray crossed with Pupstia Hugosa Mica. So yeah, that was my best try to pronounce it. I don't think I did a great job, anyhow. Then this one is opening up. So yeah, it's not blooming yet. And Peggy Rudd is still here, facing the window, because it has, let me check, 3-4 spikes to come. So I like to let them face in the same direction. But this spike is completely opened already. As you can see, so I have all the spikes going that way. And once they start opening up, I will turn it around, so I can enjoy the blooms a bit more. And we still have this one in bloom. It's now... Some blooms are going over, but it's a beautiful one, beautiful cross, which I don't remember the name of from the top of my head, so let me check. It's a fairly long name. So, yeah. Dick Garamorara, Pacific Dreams, Renaissance Fiddler, something like that. Yeah. What a name, but a beautiful display. Five very large spikes, as you can see. Some beauty. And then, after years, you guys, look at that. My American Beauty, I couldn't get it to rebloom, but I finally managed to do it. And I must admit, I did move them into the orchid room, but they had the spikes on already. I had them in the greenhouse, but I had a feeling they would enjoy them a bit better here. But look at those blooms. Beautiful. And as you saw, I have two of them, and I think another sheet coming, so number three is on the way as well. So it's now doing fine. My blackjack, same story. This would be the first rebloom, I think, after almost 3 years. So it did take me quite a long time with those two guys, but beautiful, I think. My jewel orchid is still in bloom, Ludicia. Then we move over to this side and we have this one. It's just starting to open up, the spike. Beautiful one. And this is the Miltonia Snowfalls, is it called, by the Incas. And this is also very beautiful. Let me check this, the idea. This is the Renaissance Coral. I see this more often with growers. So I think this is a fairly popular orchid. And I completely understand why the blooms are. I'm sorry for the backlighting, it's a bit, but it's in the evening, but I hope you can get a nice shot at the blooms. My Maysay Red with a beautiful spike. It's almost open, completely open. I thought it was completely opened already, but it isn't. Still working on some buds, but quite an amount of blooms. And the second spike is here, also still opening up. And in the back we do get number three. So yeah, this is beautiful. Let me go backwards a bit so you can have an idea. It's starting to get a fairly large orchid and I really, really love it. It's one of my favorite colors, bloom-wise. So yeah, very beautiful. Then we have a no idea. Odontoglossum type here. That one is way more red than these guys. Beautiful as well. That one is now going over. So, and I think that is it for now. Did I forget something? No. So I still have some blooms and quite some spikes to come. But I have a few newbies again. So that's very beautiful, I think. So yeah, this is my update for the month of October. Yeah, I really like this guy. Beautiful one. I really like the colors and the shape. But anyhow, yeah, I really enjoyed them all, of course. So this is, like I said, the update for October, blooming wise. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And as usual, if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section. And for now, thank you for watching, and I really hope to see you at one of my next videos. Bye bye.